Good morning, dear students, and welcome back in our biology session. So, as we know, we are discussing our lesson that is for reaching the age of adolescence. Okay. So today I have bring you very interesting and very important concept from the lesson, that is nothing but what hormone. Okay. Never say hormone. That is what hormones. Okay. So let's discuss what is mean by hormones. So in our previous video we have discussed about the secondary sexual characters, and as we know all these secondary sexual characters takes place in our body due to the one chemical substance, and the name of that chemical substance is nothing but what hormones. Okay, that is nothing but what hormones. So let's see what is mean by exactly hormones. So whatever the changes takes place in the body, that is happens, that is due to the presence or the secretion of this chemical substance which is known as what hormones. So let's see the definition of the hormones. Hormones are chemical substances which coordinate the activities of living organisms and their growth. Okay, so the hormones are the chemical substances which coordinates, okay, which brings the changes, which makes the changes, or it acts like a bridge, coordinates the activities of living thing. It helps to do the different activities of the living thing, and also it is responsible for their proper growth. Okay, so these hormones are nothing but the chemical messenger. Now chemical messenger is what? The secretion of the hormones bring the different changes. Okay, so they act like a messenger. Okay, these hormones are acts like a messenger, and that is the reason they are called as what? Chemical messenger. Okay, they are called as what? Chemical messenger. So these hormones are secreted by the endocrine glands. Okay, the hormones are secreted by the endocrine glands. Actually, I want to tell you something, that there are the two types of the glands are present in our body. Okay, there are the two types of the glands present in the human body. First one is exocrine gland, while the another one is endocrine gland. So first we'll discuss about this exocrine and the endocrine, then we will move for our point again. So what is mean by the exocrine glands? Okay, so these are the glands which release their secretion with the help of the ducts. Now ducts means, so they are having one pipe like structure, we can say that, or they are having one tube like structure. Okay, so these exocrine glands release their secretion. So the glands means what? Release the body organ which releases or which secretes some chemical substances. Okay, we can say like that. So these exocrine glands also secrete the secretion. They are also making certain types of the secretion, and they release that secretion into the certain body parts with the help of the ducts, and that is the reason they are called as what? Exocrine glands. Okay, as for example, we can say that exocrine glands, which are the exocrine glands which are present in our body, we can say that salivary gland. So the salivary glands secreted the saliva into the mouth with the help of the duct. Also we can say that digestive gland. So these digestive glands secreted the digestive juices into the digestive tract. Okay, so this digestive tract is also the, we are calling them as a food pipe. So it is also the one pipe like structure, tube like structure. Okay, so these digestive glands secreted the digestive juices in the digestive tract. So this is the first type of the gland, that is what? Exocrine gland, which release their secretion with the help of the ducts. Next one we move, that is the next type of the gland, that is what? Endocrine gland, which secreted the chemical substance which are called as what? Hormones. Okay, so let's see, this endocrine gland doesn't have any type of the duct. They don't have the duct. That's why these glands are called as ductless gland. Okay, that is the reason these endocrine glands are called as ductless glands. So if they don't have duct, if they don't have the pipeline structure, then how they release their secretion? Very interesting thing about that, these endocrine glands don't have the ducts. That is the reason they release their secretion, that is nothing but what? Hormones. Okay, they release their secretion, that we are calling as a hormones, directly into the bloodstream. Okay, they release their secretion directly into the bloodstream, and once it gets mixed into the bloodstream, Then these hormones or their secretion are transported to the whole body with the help of the blood circulation. Okay, so this is what endocrine gland. It doesn't have the duct. It is the ductless gland. It secretes the hormones that release into the blood stream, and with the help of the blood circulation, it transports it to the different body parts. Okay. After that, with the help of this blood circulation, the hormones are reaches to the certain body part, organ, cell, or the tissue where it is necessary. And that certain body part, organ, cell, or the tissue, it is called as what? Target site. Means where it exactly want to go, in that place it goes, and that place it is called as what? Target site. Okay. So once it gets mixed into the blood, with the help of the blood circulation, the hormones reaches to the exactly correct position, to the exactly where it goes to the cell, tissue, or the organ. And that site is called as what? Target site. Once the hormone reaches to the target site, then they started to stimulate that site, and that body organ started to show the different changes, or they started to give the response to the hormones. Okay. So this is about what? Hormones. Like that, endocrine glands are present in our body. There are the different endocrine glands which are present in our body, such as pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenal gland, pancreas, ovaries, and testes. Okay, so in this way, all these are the glands which are the endocrine glands, and that all these glands are present in our body. Here in the image, you can see how these glands are exactly present in our body. Okay, so these are the six glands which are present in the human body, and these all are the endocrine glands. Okay, and these endocrine glands secreted the hormones, that is nothing but what? Chemical messenger which brings or which coordinate the activities and the living organisms and their growth. Okay, and now we will move for the next point from the same lesson. That is, today we will discuss about role of hormones in initiating reproductive functions. Okay, so role of the hormones, as we know, in our previous lecture we have discussed about the hormones. So the hormones are the chemical messenger which brings the so many changes in our body, or on cells of puberty, or during the puberty so many changes occurs in our body, that all the changes takes place because of these hormones. Okay, so these hormones are the chemical substance which are secreted by the different glands, or we can say that what, these are the substances which are secreted by the endocrine gland, which are also called as what? Ductless glands. Okay, so in this way, the endocrine gland or the ductless gland release their secretion into the blood stream, and with the help of the blood, it reaches to their body parts or their particular body organ, and that part is called as what? Target site. Okay. So as we know, there are the different hormones are secreted in our body. So on the state of the puberty, once the puberty started, and there so many changes takes place in our body started to secrete different hormones which helps to make the body ready for the reproductions. Okay, so because of these hormones, so many secondary sexual character takes place in our body, that we have already seen in our previous video. Okay, and also these hormones helps to mature. Because of these hormones, the testes in the male and the ovaries in the females are getting mature, and they started to release the male and the female sex gamete. Okay, so as we know, in the male, the sex gamete is what? Sperm. While in the female, the sex gamete is what? Ova or the eggs. Okay, so in this way, because of these hormones, these testes or the ovaries are getting mature. But as we know, these hormones are under the control of the hormones which are secreted by the pituitary glands. Okay, so all these sex hormones are under the control of the another hormone which is secreted by the pituitary glands. Okay, so many hormones are secreted by the pituitary gland. Among one of the hormones, because one of the hormones, the testes in the males are get mature and started to secrete the female sex hormone, that is what? Testosterone. And because one of the hormones which are secreted from the pituitary gland, because of that hormones, the ovaries in the females are getting mature and started to release the female sex hormone, that is what? Progesterone. Okay, so let's see how it exactly takes place. So hormones from pituitary stimulate testes and ovaries to release the testosterone in male. Testosterone is what? Male sex hormone. Why? Because of the hormones from the pituitary in the female, they are also getting mature, the ovaries are also getting mature, and ovaries starting to secrete the female sex hormone, that is what? Progesterone in female. Okay, so these ovaries started to secrete the progesterone in female. In the male, testes get mature, started to release the testosterone. Why this happens? Because of the hormones which are secreted from the pituitary gland. Okay, next one, we'll see that these all released in the bloodstream and reach part of the body. Okay, so these secretions get mixed into the bloodstreams and reach part of the body, and that part of the body is called as what? Target site. Okay, and once it reached the target site, it started to stimulate the change in the body at onset of puberty. Okay, so when these secretion reaches to the target site, then it started to bring the certain changes in that particular body part, and therefore that we are calling as what? Onset of puberty. Okay, they stimulate the changes in the body at onset of puberty. Okay, so in this way, these are the hormones which plays a vital role in the changes of the body during the puberty. Okay, so this is about what role of hormones in initiating reproductive functions. Now we'll move for the next point, that is about reproductive phase of life in humans. Okay, so as we know, from the age or during the adolescence period, certain changes started to occur. Our body slowly get mature for the reproduction. But how much longer it will remain, how much longer our body is capable for the reproduction? So let's find out the answer for this question. So generally in the female, okay, generally in the female, they are ready for the reproduction, or their reproductive phase begins at the puberty or during the age at 10 to 12 years. Okay, 10 to 12 years. Okay, so as you know, we have discussed in our some previous sections that females are getting more mature. As a if we talk about the reproduction, or if we talk about the onsets of the puberty, their girls are getting mature so earlier than the boys. Okay, so their puberty period starts at the age of the 10 to 12. Okay, so their reproductive phase begins in female. We are talking in female, the reproductive phase begins at 10 to 12 years, and most probably it will last approximately 45 to 50 years. Okay, 45 to 50 years. Okay, so it starts at the age of 10 to 12 years and lasts till 45 to 50 years. Okay, so once the females get mature, as we know, the ovaries are also getting mature. The ovaries started to, one of the ovaries started to release the egg. Okay, at the same time, the uterus becomes so much thick. And why it is so much thick? Because once the ovary releases the eggs into the fallopian tube, if it will get fertilized, then what will happen? It will get converted into the zygote, then embryo, and then that embryo get embedded into the ovary, and then it gets started to get developed, and that only we are calling as what? Pregnancy. Okay, but what happens if the eggs will not get fertilized? Okay, if the eggs will not get fertilized, then that eggs and the thickened wall of the uterus, or the thickening wall of the uterus, are get shed off in the form of the blood and the muscles, and they comes out from the female's body, and that only called as what? Menstruation. That phase is only called as what? Menstruation. Okay, so this menstruation is occurs within the month, or their period of the menstruation is what? Occurs at 28 to 30 days. Okay, 28 to 30 days. Within the 28 to 30 days, this same process takes place again and again. The blood and the blood vessels and the muscles through comes out through the vagina, and that really called as what? Menstruation. Okay. So the first menstruation flow takes place in the female. Then that first menstruation flow is called as what? Menarche. That first menstruation flow is called as menarche. Okay. So once it gets started, initially it becomes what? Irregular. Okay. It will take some time to becomes a regular. And next one is that this menstruation remains into the female up till the age or at the age of the 45 to 50, okay, 45 to 50, okay, and after that, that stop, the menstruation flow gets stopped, or that menstrual cycle gets stopped, okay, so that stopping of the menstruation cycle is only called as what? Menopause. That is called as what? Menopause. Okay. So two concepts are there, very important. So the first menstrual flow in the female, it is called as what? Menarche. While the stopping of the menstrual cycle at the age of 45 to 50, that stopping menstrual cycle is called as what? Menopause. Okay. So at the 45 to 50, the MC, that is only what? Menstrual cycle stops. And that is only called as what? Menopause. Okay. So see here, once in the 28 to 30 days, one of the ovary releases the egg. If it get fertilized, then the further development takes place and it get embedded into the uterus, and there the it will started to grow. For that we are calling as what? Pregnancy. But if this process doesn't happen, then what happens? The egg, and along with the egg, the thickened wall of the ovaries, okay, it comes out in the form of the blood and the muscles, and that only we are calling as what? Menstruation. That menstruation occurs within the month, that is in the 28 to 30. The cycles is of the 28 to 30 days. Okay. So within that 28 to 30 days, this process is happen. If the egg gets fertilized, then woman become pregnant. And if the eggs doesn't get fertilized, then that eggs and the blood vessels flow out from the body in the form of menstruation. And that menstruation cycle occurs, that is 28 to 30 days. So this menstruation cycle occurs once in a 28 to 30 days. This menstrual cycle is also get controlled by the hormones. Okay, so as we know, all these changes are controlled by the hormones. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the hormones, target side. Also, we have discussed about the productive phase of life in man, human beings. Also, we have discussed two new concepts, that is what? Menstruation, menarche, and the menopause. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.